The Democratic Party, they of little brain and less brawn, managed to cede the country and Congress to the Republicans in 2009. They had a lot of help. But what they haven't yet learned, it seems, is that the winners, they have no brain and nothing but muscle, have put themselves into an identical situation, losing, losing big. And if the Democrats are lucky and the Republicans continue to be stupid, 2016 will be the year the GOP implodes. Here's why. If you spend 8 years screaming no at the top of your lungs, people are going to notice. And the man on the street is neither deaf nor dumb, nor does he forget. The Republicans would be happier if he did, nearly the entire 8 years. Because the ordinary voter has come to believe, rightly, that the Republicans are a party in permanent opposition to anything he or she wants. It is too late in the season for the Republicans to play nice, as lately they have begun to do. Legislation of meaningful heft has actually been passed. Voters would reward this if only they could believe that the change is real. But now we come to a crisis even Mitch McConnell couldn't have foreseen. A raid on the steps of the Capitol in South Carolina are thousands of good old boys willing, no, actually aching, to display their affection and devotion to the Confederate flag and everything for which it once stood. And guess what? These guys are the remnants of Nixon's Southern strategy. Undying, unreconstructed, unable to understand why their loyalties are being attacked so viciously. We're talking about black people here. We're talking about slaves, poverty, field hands, drugs, and more kids than you can shake a stick at. These are not our people. Well, sure, once in a while, we're forced to see one or listen to one on television, but that's all for show. Underneath, things haven't, don't, and aren't going to change. As the rest of the country watches what happens in South Carolina, what we viewers are not going to have handy is a list of players, a program. Nor will each player be identified by a number or a name on the back of his sweatshirt. We're not going to be able to say to ourselves, "Well, what do you think? There's good old Uncle George. You know how he is." The men, women, and children on the sidewalks of the state capitol will also not have programs identifying that man as a Republican or that man as a Democrat. There won't be team colors. Nightly newscasters will be forced to identify the makeup of the crowd some other way. The struggle for political correctness will be mighty and hard. Of course, players could deny that they belong to any party at all. But with 90% of America's voting population in favor of gun control measures, ignoring who chooses to use their, quote, right to carry at these outings may be difficult. And as each week passes and another Donald Trump takes the stage somewhere, even if he allows that some of those people might be okay, the grave deepens. Regardless how it sounds, the Donald is in fact echoing the Republican underline every time he speaks. And if, during a debate, the Donald faces off squarely with an opponent and demands to know how that candidate's views are really any different than his, there's carnage in Phoenix or Philadelphia or even Christie and LePage's Portland, Maine. Realizing that elections are not won by voting blocs, but by the undecided and uncategorized middle to whom each candidate must ultimately play, doesn't make running a campaign any easier. Complain as people will about men and women catering only to the portions of their base, pandering is still the name of the game. Worse, in order to keep their ships afloat, politicians must keep a weather eye on the big spenders as well. What this ultimately means is that there is, in all likelihood, no candidate brave enough to speak out about what he or she cares for, which means simply that we're voting blind again. We don't see a hero in the distance emerging, although we'd love to be able to do so. we're voting to hope again. And as the saying goes, how did that work for you last time? After 8 years of hearing no, we have no one positive and experienced enough to be certain of where he or she can stand solidly and strongly. We doubt the next year and a half will change this, which is how the elephant's trunk became its tail. I'm John Neufeld.